what I did was I asked Nick, I said, Nick, when you spoke to him at the Grand Tower presentation, he said, John, he said, did your employer do speeches? I said, well, no. He said, well, why would I, you know, I can't, I'm not, that's not what I do. So I said to him, but Nick, it's guts to do. I'll do it. So here he is. Now, so there's no rehearsing, there's no script. I've got the script, he's not got the script. So we're just going to talk to you, and I'm going to get Mick to talk to you about his experiences. So this is real life stuff. This is not rehearsed. There's no agenda here. So we're going to just talk and just see what comes out. So Mick, tell us just a little bit. Where did you work? Where have you worked before? What have you done before?
Well, before going to town, so I worked in Manchester. I moved up to Manchester 30 years ago. Worked there at the airport. Unfortunately, got.
What was that, security?
No, it was actually working at the loading the planes.
Right,
so,
yeah.
Unfortunately, got made redundant.
Okay.
Stayed up there, tried to find another job. Tried up there for 2 years. And then it didn't work out up there. So I decided to move back down south.
Okay.
Yeah. Moved back down to my mum's. Nice. Mother's cooking.
Always go back to your mum.
So I was unemployed at, still here for 3 years, kept trying everything, went to the job centre, done a welding course, done forklift training courses, still couldn't get a job. And then one day I walked in there and they obviously introduced me to the Grand Tavern scheme.
So you just go into the job centre one day and the Growing Talent was there,
obviously the woman I was here suggested it and I said I'll do anything to get work. And obviously,
so then what, you went on the selection,
and then obviously come up to the building and obviously sit down the table with all the different employees.
Went to all the different employees,
obviously this is what they had to say. I must admit, the one I went to.
You've got to do a little bit of advertising.
After 5 minutes, I was sold to the company.
Right.
And I haven't looked back since because I'm glad I did get chosen by them.
Right.
Because like I say, that treated me very, very well.
Okay, so you started work with them. Started on the course on the this is what, 2 years ago?
Two years this February.
Right. Okay.
So you start with them.
Yeah.
And the good thing about it is you can actually show what you're capable of rather than sending CVs to all these different jobs. And my age, I'm 60 now, so I thought I'd never get the chance. You know, it might take longer to get a job. But, with Howard Green, gave me the start.
And he won't tell you this bit, but I just found this bit out. He started off moving the crates, then he's driving, he's now the yard supervisor, and that's in 2 years. One of the things you've got to remember, you can be anything you want to be in life, so long as you really want to do it. So I can remember, I think, when he was doing one of the courses, saying that, and looking out into the audience, and he's sitting there, here we go. So when we had a conversation, you must remember, I said, what would you really want, if you could have anything, what would you really want? And he said, convertible Mercedes. Remember that?
Yeah.
What car are you driving then?
Convertible Mercedes.
Do you know what? Guts, determination, and a work ethic. There's living proof of it. Well, and let me see you one in the same. ladies and gentlemen, Nick Matthews.